We are so sorry because there are some problems again in group 2. Please wait.
Yeah.
No.
Okay, moderator, co-host.
Okay, Ibu Sri Nur Hayati, we have let you to be a co-host, so you can start your presentation.
Okay. Ya, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, okay. Alhamdulillah, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Here we have already my friends, ya. Dr. Rusmana is already here. Oke, okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We are from IAIN Madura, Institut Agama Islam Negeri Madura. We are going to present. Okay. Okay, we are going to present our research and analysis on the readiness of using e-learning in teaching and learning strategies in higher education. Let me open the PowerPoint for a moment and let me introduce myself. My name is Rinur Hayati and Mrs. Halimatu Sa'diya. And then here we have also Mr. Usman. Can you hear my voice?
Yes.
Yes, clear.
Okay. The PowerPoint is ongoing in opening the PowerPoint. Yeah. So we are having this research, the readiness on using e-learning in higher education for specifically, we did it in EIN Madura. It has been done in 2019 and it is very useful today because we in EIN Madura, we have to use it. We have to apply it, which is called e-learning. Okay. Sorry. Okay. Can you see my slide?
Not yet, ma'am.
Hari dari sana.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, this is us. Jamiluddin Usman, Halimatu Sa'diya, Sri Nur Hayati, it's me, and Dr. Usman. Okay, now let's continue. Before 2019, we have a traditional education. It means that we have to meet our students in the classroom, and then after this pandemic, we are forbidden to do that, right? And then we use internet and learning management system. It's an application. We are using e-learning. Okay. In e-learning, we still meet our students, but not in classroom anymore. And the characteristics of e-learning, there are four characteristics. The first one is interactivity, means that there is a bigger direct communication track synchronously. And then independency, which means that it's more student-centered learning. So it's more independent. And then accessibility means that learning sources are easier to be accessed because we can get it through the internet. And then the enrichment, just like teaching learning process, the course material presentations possibly uses information technology devices. And then it's already helpful. And after that, there are advantage and disadvantage of e-learning. The first one, it can be done anywhere and anytime, just like now. We have done it today. We know what is John Manson just now present his presentation from Australia. Yeah, and then it is cost saving. It means that we can save the cost because we don't need to go anywhere. We can save the cost of transportation. Time efficiency, yes, it's already clear, integrated. Just like this, when we meet in Zoom, we can integrate with others' devices such as PowerPoint, we can share any document. It's like that. Increases the intensity of information. Yeah, the intensity of the information must be increased. And then increases participation. The more open the network, the more people join the activity. And then the disadvantage, when we have the advantage there, we also find the disadvantage, of course. The first one, we cannot deliver the user's emotions. Yeah, just like, what is that? Facial expression, gestures, that's relative. So we cannot manage that. So that what we call is human sense. Yeah. Now we have to understand that not only saying that, but we have to think what others will think if we say it like this, like that. And need specific device, of course, hardware and software, unimportant information, so we have to select which one is suitable with us and others. Confiscates concentration. Yeah, we have to do it in the right time and in the right place. If not, we can make others confused. Okay, method. Here we are. We did the research using Aydin and Tusky model. Yeah, because we measure the readiness. We have four factors there. We use the questionnaire. We question for four factors. The first one is technology. We measure four factors: technology, innovation, human being, and self-development. And every factor see from the resources side, skill side, and attitude side. The technology, we see whether the access is good or not, the skill, whether the lecturer and the student able to operate computer or to use internet. The attitude, the positive attitude, whether they open or not. It's also happened to the factors of innovation, resources, the boundaries in adopting e-learning, the skill, we see the ability to adapt the changes. And from the attitude side, we see whether they are open or not, whether they are eager to use e-learning or not. Human being here, we see from the educated student side, experienced teachers, pioneers on e-learning, the service provider, and the external factor. The skill we measure is the ability to learn through or with e-learning. The attitude we see is the cooperation between the student using the e-learning, cooperation between the student and the teacher, the cooperation between the employee and the lecturer, meaning e-system. And then from self-development, we see also the budgeting for e-learning, how the campus give us some allocation of budget there. And then the skill, the ability to manage time, the last one, the attitude is the trust on the self-development. Yeah, so whether they believe that they can do it or not. Yeah, this is the result. Okay, this is the result from the technology. The average, the minimum score is 3.41. This is the average score. And then we have the technology score is 3. Actually here we have the score range, yeah, because it is not clear. I will tell you about the result only. The technology score is 3.59. It means that the technology is already ready, but then it needs slight improvement. When the innovation, we are already motivated, but it needs still improvement. And then the human factor, where the lecturers, we see the lecturers, the students, the employee, and the developer, we have 3.5 point. Which means that we are ready, but still need some improvement. And unfortunately, the self-development, we only have 3.28 score, which means that we are not ready in the self-development. So that conclusion, the readiness level of using e-learning in AI in Madura is only 3.55. It means that it's already ready. We are already get ready for the e-learning, but it needs some improvement. when we see here, ready, 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 and the self-development is not ready. For self-development, there are two sides that we are not so ready enough, which is in the form of the student.
Time is up.
Oh, time's up. Okay, that's all. So we can conclude that EIN Madura is already in the time of ready in using and applying e-learning. Yes, we need to be more confident to do it. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Ibu Sri Nurhayati. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome our second presenter. It is Ibu Elok Fitriani from EIN Tulung Agung with the title, The Effectiveness of Research-Based Learning in the Inferential Statistics Course in the Islamic Economics Department of EIN Tulung Agung. Ibu Elok, the floor is yours.
Okay, I want to share my screen. Please be co-host.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Can you hear me?
Yes. We can hear you clear.
Okay, thank you. Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, moderator, for time to ask. Let me introduce myself and my partner. I am Elok Fitrian Rafika Sari, and my partner are Mr. Ahmad Supriyadi and Mrs. Fitri Handayani from Institut Agama Islam Negeri Tulungagung. Next slide. In this presentation, I will explain about the effectiveness of research-based learning in the inferential statistics course in the Islamic Economic Department of EIN Tulungagung. For introduction, this research is very important to us as we know that quality education can be obtained from quality learning process because quality learning process must be able to create competitive situation. In our department, one of the course that students need to understand more seriously is inferential statistics. This is because this course is needed to analyzing research data, especially for their thesis. In fact, more student thesis in our department only focus on correlation and regression, though many other methods can be used in analyzing research data. This is due to the lack of student understanding in inferential statistics course. So we can say that inferential statistics requires special learning strategies and we choose research-based learning. Because based on previous research, research-based learning can improve student knowledge, cognitive ability, critical and thinking ability, and from Chulapon research on 2017, conclude that RBL is more effective than conventional learning method, that same with Wanabiron research on 2014 in ICT course. Okay, next I will tell you about our stage of research in this flowchart for method. First, we make lecture plan that use RBL in the learning process, make the evaluation instrument, applying RBL, and conduct an assessment. Next stage is data tabulation and see data descriptive analysis and test the hypothesis about data distribution. If data in normal distribution, we can use parametric tests with independent sample t-test. But if not, we can use non-parametric tests with Mann-Whitney test. And the last stage is determine the best learning method. Okay, this is our descriptive data analysis. This table show the average value of students using research-based learning greater than conventional method. And from the standard deviation, we know that research-based learning data more homogeneous than conventional. And from the histogram, we know that data not in normal shape. So we can know that data not in normal distribution, but we need hypothesis testing to conclude that. Okay, next slide. Okay. About normality data testing, first, null hypothesis is data in normal distribution, and alternative hypothesis is data not in normal distribution. From Kolmogorov-Smirnov test output from SPSS, we know that the result of significant value both research-based learning and conventional data is 0, less than 0.05 or alpha. And we can conclude that reject null hypothesis or data not in normal distribution. So we can use Mann-Whitney test or non-parametric test for the next stage. For Mann-Whitney test, we have hypothesis testing. Null hypothesis is mu1 equal with mu2, and alternative hypothesis is mu1 not equal with mu2. Mu1 is for RBL data and mu2 is for conventional data. From the analysis, we have significant value 0.02 less than alpha 0.05. And from this, so we can reject the null hypothesis. Okay, next slide. Okay, from the result, significant value 0.002 less than alpha and 0.05. So we can conclude that mu1 not equal with mu2. And from the hypothesis testing and descriptive data analysis before or table before, we can conclude that result-based learning more effective than conventional method. I think enough for my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention. And wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much, Ibu Elok Fitriani. Now we come to the question and answer session for the first session. As I told you before, you can ask a question by clicking the button raise hand, or you can type the question in the question and answer box. Would you please ask a question to the presenters, Ibu Sri Nur Hayati and Ibu Elok Fitriani? When you ask question, please mention your name and also state which presenter address your question. Anyone of you who want to ask question directly, would you please raise your hand? No question for the two presenters. Bapak Haridika, maybe you want to ask question? No?
No. That's good.
Okay. If everything is okay, so let's continue to the next session.
Yes, please.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
Let's continue to the next session for the second session of this group. We will have Bapak Minhatul Ma'arif and also Ibu Ana Rahmawati. For the first, I will invite Ibu Ana Rahmawati to present the article with the title "The Perspective of the Sandri Tahfidz Quran on the Interface Display of the Android Quran Memorization Application." Okay, and please, Ibu Ana, the floor is yours.
Can you see my slides?
Yes.
Can you see
myself? Yes, we can see.
Okay. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Let me introduce myself and my partner in this article. My name is Ana Rahmawati. I'm lecturer in Uniso Jepara, Here I would like to present my presentation entitled The Perspective of the Santri Tahfidz Quran on Interface Display of the Android-based Al-Quran Memorization Application. Thanks for the chance for me to deliver my presentation today. Introduction. The impact of the non-natural disaster in the form of the COVID-19 pandemic, which started in Wuhan, China, which later became a global disaster, is the cessation of the learning process that has been happening in educational institutions, teaching and learning activities at various levels and types of education, including pesantren education stopped and were replaced by distance learning model. This incident is good opportunity to introduce and practice learning using online media. The study aims to determine the perceptions of the Santri Tahfidz Quran on appearance of Android application media for memorizing the Holy Quran. Research method. This study uses qualitative method and field research. Data collection techniques use questionnaire and interview to santri in Tahfidz Islamic Boarding School in Jepara, Kudus, and Pati. Data analysis through reduction, display, and providing inclusion. The result. The result of the needs analysis on the characteristic of the student interest in the appearance of media and the learning atmosphere of the student at the Darut Ta'lim Jepara Islamic Boarding School as shown in the following figure. Figure 1 shows that 19% of students like media that contain image much as 8% of students like the application. There is a video display. There are 16% of students who are learning with the game system. It is the same as the percentage that likes group. Meanwhile, in option, we can see that as many as 16% of students like applications that include writing in them. And then the result of the analysis of the needs of the Yanbu'ul Quran Menawan Kudus Pesantren are more or less they are 19% of students like learning media or application that display image. Students who like learning media have video elements are 13% and 15% are happy about the learning technology in the Tahfidz program. As many 10% of the students like the application with the writing in it, their results are in line with the student answer options A and B as shown in figure 2 below. And now the result of the analysis of the student interest in PP Yanbu'ul Quran Boarding School One Pati to appearance learning atmosphere of choice A and choice B. Figure 3 shows that there are 17% students who are interested in displaying image media and students who are interested media in the form of video are 15%. And 12% are happy about learning technology. There are 16% of students will like to learn using the game method. Figure 3 shows that 14% of the students are more interested in writing medium. And no conclusion from the result of the analysis and discussion of the data above, we can result that 18.5 0.3% of the students who memorized the Quran from three Islamic boarding school, like the pictorial Quran memorization application, as much as 12% of students like applications that include video elements. And then 14.6% of the TAFID student who were test one game element in Android application for memorizing the Quran. Meanwhile, 13.3% of students like application that use Arabic writing. Thanks for the chance for me to deliver my presentation today. That's all my presentation. That's thank you for your attention and see you next time. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much, Ibu Ana Rahmawati. And now let's continue to the second presenter of this session. Please welcome Bapak Minhatul Ma'arif with the title The Effect of Sephora and Post Viewer on Students' Ability in Discovering Research Ideas. For Bapak Minhatul Ma'arif, the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you so much for the time.
Stop the screen.
Yes.
Ibu Ana Rahmawati, would you please stop the screen? Okay. Let's continue, Bapak Minhatul.
Okay, thank you very much to the time moderators. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Minhatul Ma'arif and my research partner, Reza Fauzi. Is that my voice?
Yes. It's me, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. The title of our presentation is The Effect of Sephora and Post Viewer on Students' Ability in Discovering Research Ideas. And then our research background. Our research background is encouraged by the low ability of students to find research ideas in study methodology course. As we know, in the preparation of the final test on the course of the methodology, such as making short proposals, article, or papers, many students feel difficulties, especially in determining research ideas. But at the end of this course, students are required to be skilled in analyzing the problem in order to find the relevant research idea to be a short proposal. As for getting all that, students should be able to analyze many articles to get the novelty of the idea to be used. There are many ways to discover new research ideas, such as through literature study and bibliometric analysis. Later, the bibliometric analysis is widely chosen because it is accurate and easy to do. And the bibliometric analysis is performed by collecting various articles from year to year to find research opportunities through research map visualization. Research purpose. The goal of our research is to test effectiveness of Sephora with the help of Post Viewer in enhancing the ability of students to find research help, to find research ideas in writing papers and articles. And Sephora is a search engine of web-based research article using the big data meaning method or various scientific research journal publishers. Using filtering method based on impact, rating, and sorting methods based on relevance level with the search word for letter result are displayed and downloaded by user with impact factor data, sorted by relevance and impact. And after student get an article, then they can analyze the article. There are several ways of analyzing article as research have mentioned above. In this experimental research, researchers use the application visualization of similarity, post viewer, or we call it post viewer. You know that post viewer is used to analyze the network, counting the number of article, quotes, research trends by year and the year, desired topic of libraries, question, co-citation, co-authorship, and co-occurrence. Please, in research methods. Research methods, the method used in this study was a quasi-experiment. Experimental groups compiled article using Sephora and analyzed them to find research ideas using post viewer, while the control group compiles article using Sephora but analyzes research opportunity manually. The population in this study was 20 lecturers and 200 students. But based on simple random sampling, which researcher used samples obtained 122 people consisting of the student and lecturers of three colleges in Pandeglang, Banten. This study was conducted for 2 months, starting from January until February 2020, with 8 meetings simultaneously. The result of the research. The results showed that the experimental group was superior to the control group with a score of 40.53, while the control group was only 36.81. Next. Okay, this is the image of Sephora based on web-wide, and then this is the result of Sephora when we find the ideas or the journal or the title of the journal. And then this is the post viewer. So and this is an overview of the mapping visualization result of post viewer. Okay, that's all our presentation. Thank you very much for the audience. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you very much, Bapak Minhatul Ma'arif. And now let's come to the question and answer for this session. Please ask question by typing on your chat or raise your hand. I think it is a very interesting from Bapak Minhatul. It is new for us. Maybe some of you want to ask what is it in detail, please.
Okay, please, any question?
Moderator, please, okay. I have questions.
Okay, there is a question. Pardon me, Pak Hari.
Yes, thanks before. Okay, I have a little questions for Mr. Arif, Mia Ma'arif, ID Mia Ma'arif. The paper tell about post viewer and Sephora. So I want to ask something. Why Mr. Arif and team choose the Sephora web? And how many data you can download from Sephora web to export or to use in post viewer? Second, the last questions. How to explain or how to mining in phosphor that connection in one circle with another circle. That's it. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Baba Haridika, for the question. It is very good question. I think Baba Bin Hatul Ma'arif, can you answer the question? The first question, why do you choose Sephora and PulseViewer? And then how many data that you can download from this engine? Okay, Baba Hari, please answer directly the question. Baba Bin Hatul.
Okay. Sorry. Thank you. It is a good question. My voice clear?
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
thank you clear. Very much. Okay. It is the continued research. Why we choose Sephora and PulseViewer? The first is we always especially students got difficulty when they how to get the main idea or how to get the idea of how to make a simple proposal or how to make a simple thesis or the article or the paper. It is the main point. And Sephora is the continuing we make before. We make a development application and development web to make easy to collect all the data research. And then I think Sephora and PulseViewer is very easy to use and very easy to make all the researcher, especially the students of to make a final task.
Okay. Does it answer your question, Bapak Hadi?
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Mia Marif.
Okay. Thank you, Bapak Muhadu. And then the next question goes to Ibu Ana Rahmawati. Ibu Ana, there is a question from Ibu Halimah. Yeah, from IAIN Madura. The question is, what is your research purpose by surveying to the students in Tahfidz School? Ibu Ana Rahmawati, would you please answer the question?
Repeat it once again.
What is...
The signal is not good here.
Okay, I'll repeat the question. It is from Ibu Halimah Sa'diyah from IAIN Madura. The question is, what is your research purpose by surveying to the students of Tahfidz School? What is your research purpose by surveying to the students of Tahfidz School?
Oh. Now, because this research, we can see that what I say 18.3% of students who memorize the Quran from the like the pictorial Quran memorizing application. As much as 12% of student like application that include video elements. That's inside there is video elements and 14.6% of the Tahfidz students who were test one game element in an Android application for memorizing the Quran. And 13.3% of student like application that use Arabic writing in the application.
Okay, enough, Ibu. Okay, I hope that it can answer the question from Ibu Halimah Tusadia. Because of the limitation of the time, I will end from this session and let's continue to the next presenters for the next session. Thank you very much, Ibu Ana Ramawati and Bapak Arif. Let's continue to the next presenters, Bapak Yuni Suprapto and Bapak Hari Gita. For the first is Bapak Yuni Suprapto from Universitas Peradaban Brebes with the title The Development of Fico Mafa as Android-based disaster learning media for the PGSD students of Universitas Peradaban. For Bapak Yuni, the floor is yours.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
So I'm introduce myself. I'm Yuni Suprapto from Universitas Peradaban. I want to share my screen, but in Zoom. Not connect. Has disabled participant screen sharing.
Okay, the committee will help you to share the screen.
Okay. This is my paper. The title, The Development of Fico Mafa as Android-based Disaster Learning Media for the PGSD student of University Peradaban. Background, Universitas Peradaban has a number of departments, including the primary school teacher training education department, because the student to develop their competency to share their role in the society through a number of ways, including one, the application of knowledge, technologies, and art in teaching and learning activity, two, the development of beneficial learning process, and three, the development of problem solving capability based on the research in an attempt to improve the learning quality, and four, the responsibility to work as primary school. And the background, with the regret to the background of study, the research discussed a coverage related to the development of Android-based video and comic application as the disaster learning Fico Mafa for the PGSD student of Universitas Peradaban. Next, relevant studies, Bertolucci and Magni, 20 and 16, Wang, 20 and 16, and Tati B and Mats, 20 and 15, and the methodology as R&D model Fenrich is a 7 states in methodology. Please next the slide. In first years, I take data analysis in disaster in Brebes, split two disaster, flood and landslide. And second years, I want to plan the analysis in first years. In first years, design Fico Mafa and development, and second years is implementation. Finding back to slide, finding the table validation of content of Fico Mafa. Fico Mafa have 9 content, flexibility, clarity, and objective. Clarity of 5 application function and coverage, cohesion, language quality, capability, compatibility, and accessibility. Total 26.5 58. Mean value of content validation of VicomAlpha based on its indicator. Mean value of content validity 100% V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, V7, V8, V9, V10, V11, and V12. Next slide. Model summary. ANOVA sample statistic, ANOVA coefficient, and we look the summary and predictor standard error of estimate 4.824 per sample statistic, standard error mean pretest 1.260 and post-test 1.188. Standard deviation in pretest 11.06 and post-test standard deviation 10.42. Next, coefficient and recommendation. The development of video and comic through the Android-based application VicomAlpha for the disaster education which foster the understanding of disaster preparedness for the PhD student of Universitas Peradaban. Next. Thank you. I'm sorry to all participants. Please put the ponsel. Is application VicomAlpha.
Okay.
Okay. We going to Play Store, Google Play Store. Android based di Google Play Store. We type the VicomAlpha.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. So in VicomAlpha, install and to state about us comic and video. And in VicomAlpha have a comic landslide and plot in dialect Ngapak Brebes.
Okay.
So it's very easy for student in PGSD. Okay. Thanks for the attention for me this time to moderator. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you very much Bapak Yuli Suprapto from Universitas Peradaban Brebes. Now let's continue to the next presenter, Bapak Hari Dika from Universitas Indraprasta PGRI Jakarta.
Thank you moderator. Yes. Okay. I will try to share screen. Host disabled participant screen sharing. Would you please committed to share my slide, please? Because I click the button of share screen. There is a disabled with host.
Okay.
Would you please help me?
Okay. Yes. I'll wait for a moment.
Okay. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
This is our research for first time introduce me. My name is Hari Dika. My friend is Fitriana Destiawati Sulajo, and the last name is my student Musa Jaya. Okay. This is our research the last year. For the plan is 5 year, but the Ministry of Higher Education choose there is 3 years. The title is the effectiveness of learning management system in learning media using Moodle with the blended learning concept. Okay, next please. Okay. In introduction, we focus to an electronic learning system has been developed. So we have developed LMS or learning management system. Point electric learning application of technology in education, e-learning to support online learning. Several years ago, we have a concept to use to implementation learning application to high school in Jawa Bali. There is 10 school. Okay, next point, blended learning for the effectiveness of LMS implementation. We must weaken implementation learning management system to high school. Okay, next please. Okay, we use the method first analyze LMS and its implementation. So after we analyze the learning management system and we increase, we develop and we implementation to higher school. Then a quality descriptive, we have a object, a condition, system of truth, function. We must see how to LMS operate. Next point, research object. We must we focus to teachers, students, and parents. In this LMS, we in this object we choose the high school in Jawa and Bali. Jawa, Bali. Okay, next. Result and discussion. Okay, we create an interactive web as a learning media, online web. There is online web. And then a modular object-oriented dynamic learning environment. We call a Moodle. Moodle is a LMS that we increase, that we custom to give at a school. And then web e-learning is used to support electric learning. Okay, next. Okay, this is LMS percentage. If a Moodle, there is a top of one in the world, Moodle have a 65% in the world. Okay, next. Okay, this is a Moodle administration site that we cite from Sok Velee Al-Ajatan et al. At 28. We have increased this model and we give a school. We give to a headmaster school. Next, please. Okay, this is the web we was created. Okay, this is Belajar Interaktif. So you can choose, so you can open your browser. Then your browser, you must type Belajar Interaktif. So they can show you a Moodle learning activity or learning management system Belajar Interaktif. Next, please. Okay, LMS with blended learning. Blended learning either directly or a web media. So we must combine traditional learning and electronic learning. Next point, student can access information resource interactive. Different method can increase student interest. We must know how to increase the student interest. So blended learning with Moodle facing 4.0. Okay, next. Conclusion. The Industrial Revolution 4.0 requires school to implement a technology-based learning method. Implementation of e-learning still require direct interaction between teachers, students for the creation of good social interaction. The effectiveness of LMS learning management system with the concept of blended learning can create a cohesive relationship between teacher, student, and parents to create learning condition, a good condition to learn, especially in this pandemic, COVID-19. Next. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Baba Haritika. Thank you for the two presenters. That is very interesting topic. It's about Vicomafa and also blended learning. And now let's come to the question and answer session again. This is the last session. So please ask question to the presenters. If you want to ask, you can raise your hand or type your question to the question answer box. Please. Or everything is good, maybe.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
A question? Okay. I think there is no question. So if there are more questions, we come to the end of the presentation. We would like to say thank you very much for all presenters and also participants. And before we close, let's take a photo together. Please start your video and let's have a photo together. Bu Ana. Okay. Let's start now. They say cheese together. For the committee, are you ready? For the committee, are you ready? Okay. For the others, would you please to start your videos? You can, so we can take a photo together. Okay, let's start. 1, 2, 3. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, that's all for the presentation for today. Hopefully that the presentation will be beneficial for us. And thank you for your attention. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon and see you.
Bye-bye. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thanks, thanks.
Thank you. Thank you.